To achieve greatness in boxing takes a combination of talent, dedication, discipline and good fortune. Add to that list the importance of physical and mental strength and you have the recipe for a world-class fighter. In order to be a great fighter, one needs to possess self-confidence and a feeling of invincibility. To see a boxer who possesses all these qualities is rare. To see a boxer throw it all away is always heartbreaking. They go from something to nothing. Underachievement is an emotive word in boxing, perhaps more so than in any other sport. Underachievement in boxing can take many forms, from extracurricular activities leaving fighters distracting and lacking dedication, to promotional disputes and financial difficulties derailing career-making fights from ever getting made. Press like and notification bell for more great content, and in this new video you will see men who could have changed the boxing landscape. At 6'2" and 235 pounds, Ike Mr. President Ibeabuchi may have been the perfect heavyweight specimen.
Hands up, get moving! Oh, he's down!
Ibeabuchi, who is originally from Nigeria, immigrated to the US in 1993 and soon took up boxing. In the pro ranks, Ibeabuchi was an unstoppable force. In less than 5 years as a pro, he amassed a record 20 wins with 15 knockouts and no defeats.
Now they go swinging in the middle of the ring.
That's what they need.
Among those wins was the highly touted David Tu and brutal knockout of Chris Bird. After the Bird knockout, it seemed as though Ibeabuchi was headed for greatness and an eventual shot at the heavyweight championship. That shot would never come though, as Ibeabuchi was charged with the attempted rape and a kidnapping of a Las Vegas call girl in 1999. Ibeabuchi would eventually enter an Alford plea in the case in 2001 and has been imprisoned ever since. At the age of just 17, he won a gold medal in the featherweight category at the Olympics that year. Taylor was blessed with dazzling hand speed, outstanding footwork and blistering combination punching, and he exploited all three attributes in a rapid rise to the top of the professional ranks. In just his 21st professional fight, he stopped Buddy McGirr to win the IBF light welterweight title. 2 years later, in 1990, he found himself in a unification bout against a living legend in Julio Cesar Chavez, who held the WBC title.
Look at the speed of Maltrick Taylor's work.
He was true to his word as he delivered a boxing masterclass, nullifying Chavez's offense with his superior speed and seeming to build an insurmountable lead on the scorecard. By the final round, Taylor was exhausted and his face a swollen, bloody mess. With 25 seconds to go in the round, he staggered Taylor with a big right hand and went in for the kill. Taylor was up by the count of 6, but referee Richard Steele waved the fight off with just 2 seconds left in the round.
Unbelievable! Richard Steele stopped the fight with fewer than 5 seconds to go!
Taylor lost more than just his title and undefeated record that night. He was never the same fighter again after the punishment he took in the ring.
Belter Taylor lost everything that night.
He didn't just lose a title belt. He was never going to be Belter Taylor again.
Successive knockout losses to Terry Norris and Crisanto España and the second stoppage at the hands of Chavez in a rematch ended his career as a world-class fighter. Ayala Jr. was just 17 when he burst onto the pro scene.
I never seen such professional talent come out of a youngster.
Over the first 3 years of his pro career, he would rattle off 22 straight wins and register 90 knockouts in the process.
No body shot you cannot shake. He's on a mouthpiece of Maldonado.
because he was known for his ferociousness in the ring. Some touted Ayala Jr. as the next Roberto Duran. His name was also been mentioned for possible fights with Sugar Ray Leonard and Thomas Hearns. Before Ayala Jr. would ever get those opportunities, his career was cut short when he was charged and convicted of the brutal rape of a neighbor in 1983 when he was 20. Ayala Jr. would emerge from prison 16 years later and resume his career, but he was never the same fighter. He would go 9-2 in his comeback with 8 KOs before eventually returning to prison for a parole violation. Few boxers in the past 10 years have had a better combination of technical skill and athletic gifts than Yuriorkis Gamboa. A product of the elite Cuban amateur program, he was an Olympic gold medalist before turning professional. Gamboa has explosive power and cat-like agility. Gamboa does have achievements that most professional boxers will never approach. He was a dominant world champion and featherweight and held an interim belt and 130 pounds. Gamboa moved up in weight to take on undefeated WBO lightweight champ Terence Crawford. This was Gamboa's first loss as a professional, ending his undefeated streak. From there, he fought less frequently and lost momentum. Last December, Gamboa lost from Gervonta Davis with a 12-round TKO. He is 38 years old and looked like a shell of himself in the ring. He's had only 3 losses, but he's taken a lot of punishment, especially in the last 4 years. Edwin Valero began his professional career fighting mostly in Japan and Latin America. He competed from 2002 to 2010 and amassed an amazing 27-0 record with all his victories by way of knockout. Valero obviously possessed phenomenal power and fought with a high degree of aggression. The result, 2 world titles, an undefeated record, and emergence as a national hero in Venezuela. His manager claimed that Valero suffered from mental health issues and needed help. He also allegedly suffered from drug and alcohol abuse. Sadly, on April 18, 2010, Valero's wife's body was discovered in a hotel. Valero was arrested after admitting to the hotel security that he had committed the crime. A day after being arrested, Valero was found hanging in his cell. Until 2013, some of the top minds in boxing considered Adrian Broner, then an undefeated rising star, among a handful on the short list of Floyd Mathers, heirs apparent.
Adrian Broner, 23 years of age, a 3-division champion.
He wasn't just any rising star. Broner was thought to be one of the men capable of leading boxing into the future. A natural promoter, Broner's brash attitude made him popular everywhere he traveled in the world of new media. Broner eagerly embraces the flashy lifestyle and swagger Mayweather exudes, but doesn't seem to be willing to do the work necessary that has given Mayweather the right to be that cocky.
And Broner too!
Oh. His attitude, effort, heart and preparation too often seem like they are afterthoughts to the circus around him. But sadly for Broner, his confidence wasn't back up in the ring as he was picked off at will by the terrier like Marcos Maidana, with the Argentine scoring a deserved victory by unanimous decision.
And the new champion of the world.
In January 2019, Pacquiao outclassed the reticent Broner, who sat back in an attempt to counter, but threw hardly any punches, and landed even fewer.